Hey friends, good morning. Awesome, happy morning. And you know, we have a new friend here, Suresh. Mr. Suresh is into business coaching. A lot of us are struggling with businesses which we have started as startups or, you know, small businesses, outlets, shops. But, you know, we have to agree that not everybody is very strong in driving sales, marketing, and, you know, driving the business properly. And there are some rules which are internationally followed. These are methodologies which have been successful for large companies, and you know, there are people like Mr. Suresh who can actually drive your business to increase the efficiency. You can still run the business, it might take, you know, a couple of years, but you know, with these methodologies and, you know, some best practices which you know, people like Suresh bring in, will cut down that couple of years down to maybe a couple of months. So thanks a lot, Suresh ji, for joining in. I mean, you got like almost 3 decades of experience in, you know, business. You've worked with brands like, you know, big brands like Microsoft and other giants. And you're also helping from small scale to large scale, you know, businesses to scale up in terms of operations. So maybe you can talk about how did Suresh get into this particular passion of driving others' business and making them successful? And, you know, what are the current activities and how is it going now? So over to you.
Thank you, Ravi, and good morning to you and all the members who had been diehard fans of Work TV. I see you have hit 2 centuries of episodes, I think, already.
Yeah.
So there is a huge fan following for this particular program, and I'm honored and it's my privilege to be with you. So the first part is very interesting. How did I get here? So in spite of myself being a project management professional, and also a member, like, you know, part of Microsoft, I will tell you, I am a diehard believer of 80-20 rule.
Mm-hmm.
So that is Pareto's law. So all planning, structure, system works only for 80%. And something magical happens, which is 20%. And that is what we forget to actually focus on. So having said that, I had been an employee with multiple organizations. I was fortunate. But this entrepreneurship bug is something which was growing at a very good speed in a very qualitative manner. And 2013 is when I quit Microsoft. And let me tell you, it took 6 months for me to really realize what to do.
Okay.
So you may ask, in spite of being a project manager and professional, why the heck you did not plan? I was only busy handing over my role to my colleague at Microsoft. I was so selfless. I did not do anything planning. I was very sure I'll get into business. And answer to your question is the irony. Entrepreneurs are actually more casual, more leisure, more less responsible, happy-go-merry than the employees.
True. Ask me. 20 years I've been working, and you know, after I thought, okay, let me quit corporate life and all that came out. Yeah, I've become lazy. Honestly, I agree. I wanted to engage myself, and you know, luckily, these episodes worked out, and you know, I started getting into routine and, you know, working on myself. Otherwise, I become a lazy guy. I admit. On live, I admit I became a lazy guy.
So now 80% get lazy like you and me. Then I was surprised. Oh my God, what is happening? And thanks to my past experience, the people management expertise, the professional project management expertise, not only experience expertise, but also qualification and topped with international certification, helped me get into what I'm good at. I said, wow, I'm good at task management and people management, and the world needs that. That is where I started my coaching business. I was qualified, I was experienced, but I had no thoughts around that. And there was a huge need. And I started coaching people, and the results had been phenomenal. And because working with different businesses, from textile to bakery to food to education, I prepared a framework, which is known as Smarter Implementation System, as you rightly said. And that is giving me a very good high, because we are in a position to produce more from less. And now it became like a kick. It became like an nasha. It became like an intoxication. And I'm helping businesses using that framework, Smarter Implementation System.
Super. Good one. So how was the journey so far? You know, because I agree, you know, a lot of startups are like, you know, paisa पैसा खर्च नहीं करना, यू नो, बट थिंग्स शुड हैपन. आई शुड गेट यू नो द ज्ञान, बट आई रियली डोंट वॉन्ट टू पे यूटिलाइज सजेशंस फ्रॉम द सीनियर्स, बट यू नो आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू यू नो गेट दम ऑन बोर्ड. So a lot of such challenges are there, and a lot of coaches and mentors have been like facing this particular challenge. So how did you overcome that, and how is it going?
There is nothing to overcome, Ravi Shankar. Let me tell you, the matter of fact is something we need to understand. I am sorry, but I'll give two examples which I always speak. I'm absolutely open, and somebody may contradict and sue. That's fine, but nobody did it so far because probably finally they love me. How much of risk appetite we have? Is we can calculate from two aspects. We walk to a medical shop, buy medicine for your spouse, children, parents, who are the most important people, to save 300 to 500 rupees of medical consulting.
True.
We walk across the store and have pani puri or chai or mirchi bhaji, risking yourselves, risking your loved ones. So our risk appetite is too much as far as our DNA is concerned. Once I identified, I'm absolutely fine. Let people not take coaching services. There are only few people who don't want to take that type of risk all the time. And they are the people who are willing to pay. When I understood that, I give a lot of free service. I am available on telephone. People call me and take consulting. I'm absolutely fine whether they come back or not, because the risk appetite is so high. In case they think the money they pay me is going to give them three times, they will pay me. Till such time, they want to take free, and it's absolutely fine. So till such time this awareness happens, people will struggle is what I think. And for me, now my calendar is full. I'm absolutely happy. Things are going very well.
That's a nice thought process. I mean, in terms of, you and people also will get to know you well in those initial interactions, and then get comfortable, and then, you know, take it forward.
They have to check, okay? They have to listen to you. They have to understand. Love at first sight does not happen in business. They should get the confidence. We should be available.
Sure.
Yeah.
So what sort of struggles businesses have, and then they decide that, okay, let me contact Suresh ji because, you know, I definitely need help. At what stage of this thing, or what burning happens, and then, you know, they come into this decision?
That's a very nice question, because I had been an entrepreneur now for 7+ years after quitting Microsoft in 2013. And people came back to me after 2 years, after 1.5 years, after 3 years, who were sort of a warm lead 1.5, 2 years back. And again, they came back. When they came back, there was no discussion. Straight they signed up. So probably they went through the so-called do-it-yourself channel, searching on YouTube, searching on Google, finding, preparing their own notes and working it out. And they felt 2 years into, even if they lose 50,000 per month, is 6 lakhs into 2, 12 lakhs they have lost, and plus intangible element. Now probably paying is a good thing instead of doing R&D. So such people are there. And answering your point, that is, which type of people come? I observed majority of the people come to me with proactive approach. Probably my temperament and the way I attract my clients are people who are optimistic, who are upbeat, and who want to do something really big in life. I had a client who said, I want a passive income of 10 lakhs per month. So defining passive income itself takes time, because there are different school of thoughts. And I went through so much of learning, I know the language. And the second thing is reactive. Suresh bhai, gaya kaam se, everything is gone. Now what do we do? First is coming, I have to pay so much of salary, and these outlets are there where I have to pay rental. And you know, it is scary. What do we do now? So that is the reactive mode. If I look at today, 30-35% is reactive, 65% is proactive, which is the story before pandemic. Okay. So during pandemic, north became south, black became white, positive became negative. So story is different.
In any
because we used to feel very happy when something is positive. Now, if you say positive, no.
Positive so is a new scare now. So, any stories during pandemic? Any success stories during pandemic which you didn't believe, but you know it happened.
Oh yes, I can share about Krish Fashions, and I had been working with this client for almost about six eight months before pandemic.
Mm-hmm.
And one among the discussion during coaching was how do we go digital, how do we go online. At Microsoft, I was instrumental, and I can take the pride that my team and myself were the people who moved the first 1 million mailboxes from on-premise to cloud.
Oh.
So today, what you see, Office 365, Business 365, I can claim, you know, good amount of contribution was there from my side. So that got into my DNA. So when this Krish Fashions, we were discussing why not we go digital, why not we go online, it was kept aside because the business was going very well. The moment pandemic hit, first 15 days, negative. Then we got onto a call, next 15 days, my client's products are available on Flipkart, Amazon, that, this, and all that. And then long story short, we went ahead with Reliance and Udaan for wholesale. And now my client's workshop, warehouse, instead of 3,000 square feet, now we are hiring 12,000 square feet of warehouse.
Wow. Super.
So such stories are there where we did very successful during pandemic. And Ravi, I will tell you, we did not slow down. We did not, get impacted. We are doing much more, and all my clients.
Super, good one. So, any other hidden secrets?
Can you be a bit specific? Because hidden secrets are many in which direction.
Okay, so let's jump on to some rapid fire questions. Maybe some of them will come up. So, what was the last interesting trip you made?
Andaman Nicobar.
Andaman Nicobar, you liked it? I mean, what was unique?
I liked it, and thanks Ravi for bringing this, because this is something I always wanted to tell to all my fellow Indian brothers and sisters. At least from my side, I was not having Andaman Nicobar as a part of India.
Hmm.
For some reason, okay. And when I went to Andaman Nicobar along with my family, it's a paradise. The beaches are superb. The life is serene. The atmosphere is so good. You need not go and splurge in dollars and other places. It's so easy. So, blanket recommendation. I would love to see everybody will have visiting Andaman Nicobar with family in their bucket list.
Yeah, that's in my bucket list too. So, yes. Thanks for pushing this a bit.
Yes.
Okay. So, what you've been motivating a lot of people with your coaching. So, what is the best movie, that motivational movie that you've come across in your life?
Very good question. I will talk about two movies.
Mm-hmm.
One is Chakde. I use clips of that as a leadership. And the second one is Luck. There is a movie by name Luck, and I think it is Sanjay Dutt's. He bets on human beings who survive death. Beautiful movie. And I am so crazy. I think I don't tell this to much of people, and I'm glad, there is something coming up because of your power of questions. I watch the movie Luck when I am low. I don't watch the movie. Let me tell you, I'm a very lazy guy. I watch only the preview because I want things quick, fast and done. I watch the preview. I can recollect the full movie. It's beautiful. I'll be more than happy to share, whoever wants which piece is that which makes me so inspired.
Good one. Are you a pet person? Do you like cats or dogs?
I'm forced to become a pet person. So my daughters and wife, daughters in particular, they love pet, and we have a beagle at home that is Bingo.
Mm-hmm.
And this guy, I'm not that pet a person. I do love animals. And this guy makes me understand that he needs me. So, I go sometimes weak. Bingo knows how to get job done from me.
Superb. So, is your family like, okay, they love pets, but they take care of everything. But there are some pet lovers in the family. They only pet them. But rest of the activities in terms of cleaning and all that is outsourced to the person who generally doesn't like it. So, what's your story at your home?
It is all done within the family.
Okay.
So, it's a crazy fight or fun we have.
Mm-hmm.
So, just to answer this, for anything intake, eating and drinking and all that, my Bingo wants my wife. And anything out, he wants me to take for a walk and he wants to pee or a poo, you know, that is where. And children take care of the medical thing, tablets, medicine and all that. So, we don't have any outsourced person per se. It's within the family.
You know, that exactly the second point is what I wanted to hear. Okay. So, strangest hidden talent where, you know, your friends, clients, you know, they get very close to you and then they come to know about a very strange hidden talent of yours, which generally, you know, which is not on Facebook or, you know, a lot of people outside who are just virtual friends following you are not aware of.
It is not that hidden, but when people spend half an hour, 45 with me, one to one, they say, I know you so much, but now I know you better.
Mm-hmm.
And for that, two things are working if I have to go deeper. One is my interpersonal skills. So the competency definition of interpersonal skills from Microsoft parlance is understanding a person from the said and unsaid words. So I really am blessed that I understand people from the unsaid words. So once that connection happens, it's completely magical. And the second thing is empathize. So I can empathize with a 10-year boy or a girl to 80-year person, men, women, employed, unemployed, a person who's going through the worst situation of life. Because I have to quote, one of my cousins said, when I was going through shit at some point of time, he said, Suresh, how can you keep a smile on your face, which is not artificial? I said, troubles in my life taught me how to ensure a person who comes to me crying will go back with a smile, if not laughing.
Got it.
So, you know, I understand people to real big element and I give warmth.
The best thing ever you got it online, whether through Amazon or any of the other platforms.
You mean purchase?
Yeah.
I am not that free to do much of shopping or purchase because everything comes because of the family. If I have to put across the two courses which I signed up and get the best value, I can quote, shall I?
Yeah, please.
Oh, okay. So, I would like to say Siddharth Rajshekar's program, which is around how to get into digital coaching and all that, was the best investment I have done. And the amount of support he provides and the structure he provides, and you know, that helped me really make my own programs, and that's what we are supposed to. Okay. And the second one is recently I signed up for a book authoring workshop from Zubin, and the way they designed it is amazing. So that was the best investment. Why I'm telling using the word investment is I must have spent $20,000 to become what I am today. Those of you who are aware, I was part of NAC, I was part of Success Gyan, I was part of Success Resource, I was part of Frontier Training. I blew money, I invested so much on these international speakers, trainers and all that to become what I am. So my foundation is rock solid and these 3-4 programs made a final twist and I topped icing.
So are you planning to write a book anytime soon?
Yes, my book is in the writing stage, which is Excellence in Execution.
No.
Because I see most of the people are having ideas, most of the people are having plans, they are not getting into execution.
Exactly.
As a matter of fact, the ebook I released is on a similar line. It has got 6 proven brain hacks to become an execution champ. That is already launched on, it's available on Amazon.
Good one. Congratulations on the
Thanks.
book, which has come.
Thanks a lot.
Would you rather travel by plane or boat? What's your preference?
I have boat. No time. I only wish I have so much of luxury.
Okay.
Because even when we went to Andamans, there was an option that you can go by water or by air. This is 3 hours, that is 3 days, and I could not afford to spend 3 days.
Hmm.
I'll go by water, boat.
Okay. Your last large conference that you went for before COVID?
Before COVID, largest conference, I will take you to Orlando.
Mm-hmm.
So it was an business conference of complete Microsoft excellence in delivery. And it was not only huge, it was like a gala conference. And I'm sure you'll agree, it was inside Universal Studio.
Oh.
So Luz is the hotel. You can imagine now, okay? So Luz is the hotel in which we were staying, and the same thing had the conference rooms. And it was on one side of Orlando Universal Studio. And one amongst the socials we had was, part of the Universal Studio was blocked for us. And that type of luxury I enjoyed while I was serving Microsoft. So, yeah, thanks for reminding me of that.
Super. So, in college or school days, where did you do a lot of masti? And what one episode which really connects you well when you talk about your childhood or college days?
One is too less for my masti history. Okay, so let me talk about... I'm a student of Rupatunga High School in Kachiguda. So there used to be this Basant Theatre which used to have a canteen.
Mm-hmm.
So every break we used to walk there to buy samosa, eat and come back. So 10 paisa was the cost of the samosa.
Oh my God.
So it used to be a round robin masti. So whoever has got whatever money, multiples of 10, everybody used to get a samosa every day. That's one. And second one, I did my engineering in Tumkur.
Mm-hmm.
That is near Bangalore, 67 kilometers. SIT, Siddhaganga Institute of Technology. Easy to relate is Siddhaganga Swamiji was the founder of this. So there we used to have tapris, the small outlets where you get a lot of food and bun and smoke and chai and all that. So we used to spend a lot of time there having bread omelette. So, these are the two things I can recall.
So, among friend circles, how are you? I'm sure you will not be talking about business when you're with friends.
No, not at all.
What Suresh brings in when you're with friends?
So, very interesting. 83-88 is when I graduated. So, it's about 10 plus 20, 30 years. All my engineering batchmates from Hyderabad are still... Pally. And not only that, our spouses are all friends. Not only that, all our children are friends.
Oh, wow. That's interesting. Next generation okay. Also being friends is
yes.
Pretty unique.
So that's very unique. And thanks to like-minded friends and our spouses and the children. Just before COVID, there was a wedding. And my friend Prasad, his daughter's marriage was there. And we were about 10 couples staying together for 72 hours. I think that was the last fun we had before COVID.
Quite memorable. Good one.
Yep.
So, do you believe that men and women can just be friends the entire life?
Very interesting. Are we not? Is the question. We are actually. The thing is the lens with which we see. So, men and women, if you are talking about extremes like co-living or something like that, I am not answering that question. I am answering a question where we had been friends, we continue to be friends. Are we together all life or not? I don't know, depending on the social circumstances and situations. But answer is yes, they can stay friends.
Super. So, what sport you felt that I should have been and, I would have been really good at that particular thing?
None. I question myself, why the heck I did not develop any interest in any sport?
We have some similarities here.
Yeah. Is it?
Yeah.
I don't know why, because I am amongst the friend circle who will live life for cricket. And I used to be the only guy who's okay to take a break, go whatever they want, bring it and give, because they don't want to miss out one ball.
Mm-hmm.
And I was not that, but I used to have friends. So similarly, any sport for that matter did not attract my attention. I love swimming. I love bicycle. I love trekking. I somehow love something which is not having the rules and the boundaries. You know, if you allow me to walk with the destination B with no mode, no plan, that looks like a sport because it's against my way of doing. I'm absolutely structured guy.
Good. I really like this particular thing because till now I was not able to explain why I don't like sports. Now I have an explain. I can repeat the same thing.
I'm glad I could add something. And I mean it because I am surprised. For some reason, I did not.
Mm-hmm.
So something very interesting in the interest of the audience. Even music is something I always wanted to. I loved guitar after seeing some movie. I loved, you know, somebody playing with a mouth organ. I loved once there's a flute. I said, no, come what may, I have to be determined. I have to learn it, blah, blah, blah. And when I got into this training and the coaching world, I understood there are multiple intelligences. And I started teaching multiple intelligences to people. And there I could understand musical intelligence is in the last for me.
Hmm.
So that day I decided I should not aspire to learn a musical instrument. I should only inspire musicians and music. And now I have full variety of music. I enjoy thoroughly. That element of, oh, I could not do is gone. That's the reason I thought I'll take, a minute to explain. Because most of us are having self-pity. Oh, I could not do, if I were to do and all that. There is a reason. You know, accept the fact there is a reason, there is a purpose for us to do something more than what you could not do. So be happy and start loving yourselves, and there is a beautiful change which happens inside us. So I stopped thinking on those lines. When can I play tabla? I can't do it. Why should I worry about it? All of us are not made for everything.
Now the final question. So if you become the chief minister with all this experience, you've got corporate.
Oh, yeah, that topic is there, right? Okay.
You've driven businesses, you're driving multiple businesses with different, you know, in different streams, different industries. With all this experience, what would you do? What are the positive reforms you would bring in if you become the chief minister?
Okay, so I'm born and brought up in Hyderabad, and the combination is my dad is from Karimnagar district, my mom is from Warangal district. I am born and brought up in Hyderabad, and typical up to intermediate, I
was... Sorry, we lost you. Yeah, now you're...
Yeah. So, I'm a typical Hyderabadi boy. And I am brought up in a situation because of my dad, who was a professor of Osmania University, and my uncle, both of them are instrumental in terms of that 1969 agitation.
Oh.
So when I go back to that, today what I feel is, when I were to be made a chief minister, first I will have a discussion and debate in terms of what is the reason for which this Telangana state was formed. And pivot three things and create a department to address those three things. Because it's not one person's fight, it is a state's fight, it is people's fight, and they had something which was missing.
True.
So that is one thing I will do. Second thing is, I really get disturbed because of the corruption. So I would like to see, using my project management and people management, I'll have a structure of eliminating corruption like eliminating polio. So I'm crystal clear in my mind, it has to come from top down. And there are five types of leaders who make it or break it. So one is the political leaders, two is the bureaucrat leaders, three is the spiritual leaders, 4 is the religion leaders, and 5 is the business leaders. So in all 5 leaderships, I would like to bring it from top to down, a commitment that will fight against corruption. So probably in 5 years of stretch, I should be in a position to do. And the third one I will be focusing is collaboration. I'll give you an example. When the Chanchalguda flyover was forming, flyover is beautiful, fantastic. The start of the flyover, end of the flyover lands into somebody's houses. Or it gets into a narrow street. There is no collaboration between one department and the other department, one contractor and the other contractor, one officer and the other officer. This is something I would like to create a big change. Forget about Chanchalguda. I am now in Bangalore, and even in Hyderabad, I am sure it is not a better story than this. Metro is supposed to be ultra-urban project. Is entrance to metro being planned properly? Is exit from metro being planned properly? Can metro function without disturbing the traffic on the road? Because this is one department, that is one department. Similarly, the runways, airways. You know, this is what I would like to look at. And there are multiple things, but the top three things which come is A, serve the purpose for which the state was formed. B, work towards corruption, because this is also another thing which was the reason. And third is collaboration, such that it becomes a role model state within the stipulated time of 5 years. And I will not do anything to come back in the elections. I will do everything such that these 5 years people will remember for ages. If they want, they'll make me again back. Else also, no problem. I would like to leave a mark. Thank you.
Super. Good one. Some nice thoughts, Suresh Garu. I mean, because some of these things are like, comes with experience. These are not, you know, stories from the books, or, you know, things cannot be learned from books itself or from YouTube. So thanks a lot for joining in this particular show. So friends, do follow Suresh Ji. He's already reached the limit of friend request. So, you know, there are two options if you have to really follow the person. One, you send a friend request. Second, you can still follow him because he's already reached that particular limit and still connected to whatever he's doing. I love the way his website is designed. His programs are pretty clear for, you know, different category of people, for different budget. And also the quality and the way he presents himself is also something which is pretty unique. And experience definitely is something which you cannot, you know, it is priceless. You cannot, you know, say, I've just started coaching, but I have, you know, 20, 30 years of experience. Experience comes with experience, the corporate experience, the challenges there and all that comes with experience. There's no doubt about it. So do get connected, do check out. Sometimes, even though you don't avail the services, just following a person like him can get you motivated. Just watch him, what he's doing, and then get to the next level.
I will tell one thing. Not even watching, copy me up front.
Yeah, you can do that. And one of the suggestions I have for people in India, there are a lot of people who follow, watch international motivational, you know, speakers, business coaches and all that. Remember, most of those things might not work in Indian atmosphere, Indian markets, Indian scenarios, Indian customer behaviors are different than who are in the US or internationally. So always have mentors who are local, who know what are the challenges, what will work, what will not work with Indian mentality. So that is what I highly suggest. A lot of people say, I watch that particular thing, this particular thing. All are international people, very motivational, but might not work here. So yeah, do follow Mr. Suresh, and thanks a lot, sir, for joining in. It's an honor.
My pleasure.
To be here.
My pleasure.
And yeah, our pleasure, honestly, because, you know, your experience talks and the way you carry yourself and all that are just, you know, just marvelous. So please do help people, because India is stronger only if the businesses are stronger. So that's when we pay better taxes, and that's where we become better India. So thanks a lot for being part of this particular journey.
My pleasure. Thanks to you and your team for the fantastic job what you're doing. Please continue what you're doing. Okay. And the same rule follows. In spite of it being hard and people may not be accepting to pay and things like that, still our journey should go 80-20.
Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot. Thank you, friends. Thanks for watching this. Have a great day ahead. Thank you.
Thank you.